If you were to Google the world's most dangerous toy, this is actually what will pop up on your screen. The Atomic Energy Lab Kit by A.C. Gilbert. It's because it comes with three sources of radiation and four uranium ores that are also radioactive. My name is Vula Saridakis. I'm a curator here at the Museum of Science and Industry in Chicago. Now, A.C. Gilbert claimed, and the makers claimed, that there was nothing dangerous about it. It really did emit very, very low amounts of radiation. But I probably would not encourage children to hold these samples next to their body all day long. Looks like a lovely little red paper suitcase with snake skin, it's not snake skin, on the outside of the box. And when you open it, you see this lovely picture of a young man who is working the Wilson Cloud Chamber. It comes with an instruction booklet, the comic book, How Dagwood Split the Atom. And it comes with a book on how to prospect uranium as well. You can use your own Geiger counter to do that because the kit comes with its very own Geiger counter with batteries. And it also comes with these rubber balls that are red and green with little rods so that you can build your own models of alpha particles. The Wilson Cloud Chamber, which you assemble so that you could actually see the vapor trails of alpha particles. The spintheroscope, just a tube with a lens, and you look through it, and then you can actually see what's called scintillations, which is basically alpha decay. It also comes with an electroscope, because it has a scale and indicator inside of it, and you look through the tube, and you can actually see how much ionization radiation comes from the particular source that you're using, and you can use either the alpha, beta, or gamma sources, or you can use one of the four uranium ores that come with the kit. They made fewer than 5,000 of these units. They were only made in 1950 and 1951, and they sold poorly. They were discontinued after only 2 years. And the reason for that is not because of any radioactivity concerns, but rather because it was expensive. It was $50. And in 1950, $50 is the equivalent of about $520 by today's standards. And that's pretty expensive. It's like a black box of science and technology, but then you open it like Pandora's box and then you play with it and then you realize later on down the road that there might be some hidden dangers there.